So this game is called Critical Mass. The only way I can describe this game is annihilate everything. Annihilate everything that stands in your way. And that's really all I have to say about that, so without much further ado, let's just get right into the action here. Those are the controls very quickly. Left mouse to fire your machine gun, right mouse to fire your rockets, shift to run. So here we are in Critical Mass. Now, even though I did say the only way I can describe this game was just annihilate everything, what you're actually doing is that, I guess you're this soldier or something, I don't know, he appears to be in the military according to the way he's dressed, and I guess you just have to kill off all of these robots, I guess? I'm not really sure what they are, to be honest. They're either robots or maybe aliens, but basically you need to kill as many of them as possible, and that's all you do in this game. That is literally all you're doing here. And the robots or aliens, you know, and just for simplicity's sake, I'm going to call them aliens. The aliens never stop coming at you, and the game only ends if you die. So the objective here is to get as many kills as possible. Also, you can see there's a lot of blood, because apparently aliens have red blood, just like humans. Or maybe they are humans, maybe they're just wearing masks or something. That's what that also looks like, but I'm not really sure what those things are supposed to be. As you can see, you can also fire your rockets by right-clicking. If there are a lot of aliens coming at you, you can fire a rocket at them, and it just kills a whole bunch of them. Also, once you get 50 kills, the AC-130 becomes activated. And when the AC-130 is activated, it replaces your rockets. You can fire the AC-130 by right-clicking, and once again, if the aliens are grouped very close together, you can kill probably tens of them in just one round. But keep in mind, though, that you have a limited number of AC-130 rounds, unlike your machine gun, which I believe has infinite ammo, and I think you also have infinite rockets as well. So I'm just going around here killing aliens, and I am dead. So that game went pretty well, I got 105 kills. So if you press P to start a game, you will activate paint mode. And in paint mode, you can color objects by shooting them, so your machine gun basically becomes a paintball gun. Also, in paint mode, if you fire a rocket, paint will explode everywhere. Also, the blood of these weird alien creatures are actually colored now instead of being red all the time. Oddly enough, though, my character's blood is still red here. Also, I can't even shoot these guys. Somehow my aim has become horrible all of a sudden. Then I happen to stumble upon this place. I have no idea what the purpose of this place is, and I just made that chair over there completely glitch out. I thought it would be a good idea to maybe hide in here, try to kill every alien creature that tried to come inside, but unfortunately that did not work because they ganged up on me and now I'm dead. The colors of this terrain are just really bland. We need to bring this landscape to life, come on. Let's color the entire terrain here. Okay, I'm dead. Fine, these guys don't want to help me repaint the land, then I guess I'll just do this then. I'm gonna use the spin-to-win tactic. I'm just going to spin rapidly and just shoot, just to see if that works. Come on, come at me. Oh my goodness gracious, look at those kills. Wow. Okay, so that tactic doesn't even work. Forget it. Alright, it's time to fire off one of these rockets here. Let's just fire it at this thing. Oh my goodness, look at all of the paint. Paint just splattered all over the place. Goodness gracious. Yeah, by the way, you can also destroy objects here. You can actually deform the landscape with your rockets. And as you saw right there, you can destroy objects with your rockets. It's kind of weird, though, how some of the droplets of paint only appear after the explosion. I'm not sure if that's supposed to happen, or maybe it's because I lowered some of the settings in the options menu. I did have to lower some of the graphical settings here because my computer can't handle the sheer awesomeness that is Critical Mass, or at least its graphics anyway, so... So if you go watch another Critical Mass video and notice that the graphics look much better in that video than they do in my video, well, that's because I lowered some of the graphics settings here because my computer was just exploding with all of the graphics settings set to high. Look at all of this paint. You know, I may be in the military, but in reality, I am actually a painter, and the landscape is my canvas, and my paintbrush is my gun, and now I will no longer be able to paint because I'm dead. It's quite a shame. It's a real shame. I even had the AC-130 ready to go. If I had fired the AC-130, I could have just made it rain paint down on the land. And look at these guys. Look at them. They're all trying to shoot me. They're trying to kill me. Why? Just because I love painting? Is that why they're trying to kill me? Just because I have a thing for fine art? That's just not right. That's not fair. I am a talented artist, damn it, and nothing can take that away from me. They may take my life, but one thing they'll never take away is my passion for painting. Look at that. It's beautiful, isn't it? Look at all the paint just splattered all over the place here. Put some more paint in there. It's amazing. It's the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. But these guys just can't see it. It's sad. It's really sad. But here's my question. Here's the million-dollar question right here. Why has this video become very dramatic all of a sudden? Why has this video suddenly become all about how much I love painting with a machine gun nonetheless, and these guys not liking the fact that I'm a painter, and that later on in life I'll probably go on to become a very successful painter, probably even join the ranks of Van Gogh. I don't even know. I don't even know. But seriously though, have you noticed how dramatic I tend to make these post commentary videos become sometimes? I don't know why I do it. I just like doing it for some reason. There's something about it that I just find makes the video better, in my opinion. Anyway, I'm dead, so forget it. That was a much better game that time, though. I got 152 kills, jeez. Just completely wrecked everyone with that sudden burst of AC-130 rounds just a few seconds ago. Well, actually, it was about 30 seconds ago, but whatever. Anyway, that's really all I have to say about Critical Mass. So, that is literally all you do in this game. So, you have to kill these creatures, whatever they might be, and you just have to kill as many of them as possible before you're dead. And that's really all you have to do. And if you want to have even more fun, then go into paint mode by pressing the P key at the main menu. So, yeah, just paint the entire landscape. I actually find that paint mode is more fun than just a regular game mode. I don't know, there's just something about paint exploding all over the place that just makes the game more fun, I find. But anyway, that's all I have to say about it. So, if you want to download this game, the link's in the description, although you don't have to download it because it's a game that was made in the Unity game engine. You can actually play it directly in your browser. But the link to this game on GameJolt is in the description of this video, so yeah. Anyway, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next video I make. Later.